lights, which is defective. When you turn it on off, it works, but I can tell it's not feeling right when I turn it on off. There is a control this morning. We use 14 American water gauge on 15 amps, 12 American water gauge on 20 amps. Black is live, white is neutral, the blue and green is the ground. Red and blue are also live colors, however, you may find white line in the switch load on a 220 240 volt circuit where the appliance does not require a neutral. So I'll show you how to replace the defective light switch and check the connections and make sure wiring is done properly behind the switch. Okay, you can hear this when I turn the switch on. See, it doesn't have any spring to it. Okay, so we'll get our defective switch out of the wall here now. Let's see what's wrong with it. Get our cover off here. We'll use the Phillips screwdriver. Okay, we'll get it out. Let's see what they did here. Very poor connections here. And there's no crimp sleeve or wire nut on the ground wires. We'll look at our wago with the white wires in it here. And as you can see, they're not down in all the way. So I push it in. Now I see that copper all the way down. That one's all the way down. I'll bring it around and look at this other one here. Make sure that's all the way down in. And see, we have a little copper sticking up on this one. So we're going to pull this one back out. I'm going to shorten it up just a bit. These are also a little bit too long, so I'm going to put these back a little bit. So with these wagos, I want to make sure I get the insulation down into this orange portion here and see the copper all the way down at the bottom. So I'm going to put this one in first. I feel the bar, push it in, see the copper at the bottom. Come over here. Same thing with this. I feel the bar, push it in. Make sure I see the copper at the bottom here. Do the same with this other white wire here. Feel the bottom. Push it in. I'll make sure I see the copper all the way down at the bottom. Like, see how all the copper is down at the bottom and I don't see any bare copper sticking up. So now I can fold this back into our box. this. Okay, so this is and as you can see they didn't even get the wire around the screw head there. That is no good. And that wasn't in the hole very good there. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut and get these ground wires here so we can get a wire nut and a pigtail in here and put them together the right way with a wire nut. So I'm going to get a piece of wire. So I'll cut a piece of tail out of my 14-2 here. Get our ground wire out here. So let's see with the shortest one here. And we'll put our wire nut on here. Ground wire floating back into our box here. That's our hot wire up here. Now we have a glass wire out of here. Look, make sure my insulation comes down into the bottom of the wagon, which it is. Okay, so this is back into our box here. We'll bring that ground wire down to over here, so it stays away from our connections. Switch out up here. Just let them lay, you know. Just let them lay it. And you know what? I don't even care. Okay, so what I do is I put my ground wire on the green screw here. Always put it on the screw in the direction of the screw turns. So now we have this ground wire over here, so when we fold this in, we'll keep it on the bottom and over away from everything there. Okay, we'll hook this one to the bottom. Ooh, it doesn't matter. We can just put a single pole switch. It's not going to make a difference. There's the root, the direction of the screw pin. So you don't get our insulation near the screw out of this one. Our ground wire down on the bottom here so it doesn't touch the panel right there. Well, if I lost my hearing. Thank you. Make sure the ground wire is down away from everything. If you look closely, you can see how the toggle is lopsided inside and how, see all the play that has there. Man, there you go, see? You don't even hear the snap. See? It doesn't have any. Listen real close. Here, there's